I am on the Amazon.com website right now, and typically the first thing that I would do when I navigate on any website is use heading navigation. So navigate by the headings that are on the page. So I would do that by just hitting the letter H on my keyboard, and it just takes me through the headings that are on the page. So I'm going to hit H now.
Zero due today, heading level 2. Link yes, heading level 2, zero due today. Link yes. Link shop deals with Prime, try before you buy. Link yes. Link sweaters. Gifts for your Valentine, heading level 2.
So gifts for my Valentine.
Link sweaters. Link bags. Blank. Winter fashion finds, heading level 2.
So it's reading me, kind of, so the headings give you an idea of what content you should expect under that heading. So
blank, heading level 2, winter fashion finds.
So winter fashion finds. So the content that's under the setting should reflect that heading.
Link all fashion, link women, blank, link men, link kids, blank. Valentine's Day gift cards, heading level 3, link shop the selection. Top deal, heading level 2. Link graphic, True Remedy Premium Organic Body Wash and Balm. Link up to 59% off, top deal.
So again, top deals, it tells you what the product is. The content under it gives me what the product is. It mentions that it's a top deal and how much off the product it is.
The Warm Dash Weather Edit, heading level 2. Viral Hall of Fame, heading level 2. Shop deals and try for free, heading level 2. Link sweaters under $1.40. Shop deals and try for free, heading level. Link sweaters under $1.40.
So, and I'm also listening to the links, and the links are very clear in conveying the information of where these links are going to navigate me to. So if I continue to down arrow.
Link tops under $1.30. Blank. Link jeans under $1.50. Link shoes under $1.75.
Right. So each one of those, shoes under $75. So when I enter on that link, I'm expecting to go to a page that brings me to shoes under $75. And if I continue to navigate.
Bestsellers and books, heading level 2. List of 30 items. Link graphic, Little Blue Trucks, Valentine, colon, a Valentine's Day book for kids. Link graphic, Baking Yesteryear, colon, the best recipes from the 1900s to the 1980s.
Again, a list of books and, an appropriate content under the heading.
Bestsellers and cell phones and accessories, heading level 2.
Okay. So.
Amazon.com, spend less, smile more.
Once I use heading navigation to kind of get a feel for the structure of the page, the next thing I want to do is I want to go back up to the page and I want to navigate. And I'm just going to use arrow navigation down through the page because, I want to see, do they have any sort of navigation menus? Where is the content to find information about like signing in if you have an account? And if there's card information and all that stuff, I want to kind of get a feel for where all those things are located. So on the down arrow now.
Skip to main content. Navigation region. Link Amazon. Hello. Select your address. All. Search in. Combo box collapsed all departments. Search Amazon. Search Amazon edit. Banner region. Navigation escape. Vert. Go button. Link choose a language for.
So it's got a search. Has a combo box where I could pick a department and then type in. My search in and then do a search for a product.
Link hello, sign in.
There's the sign in.
Account and lists. Link returns. Add orders, link zero items in cart. Valentine's Day gifts for her button. Valentine cards for kids classroom button. Valentine's Day gifts button. Kids Valentine's Day cards button.
And since we're approaching Valentine's Day, we're seeing a lot of Valentine's Day content.
Valentine's cards for kids classroom button. Valentine's Day gifts for him button. Valentine's candy button.
So overall, this site is very good, right? There's good heading structure. I understand, as I navigate down through the page by heading, what the content is that I'm expecting, and the content is there. I used arrow navigation. I was able to find a way to search if I didn't want to just try to navigate through the content on the page. I could, pick a department, do a search, and then perform that search and get search results. I see where I can sign in. I see where the card is. So it's very clear in the information that's being conveyed to me as a screen reader user. Oh, Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to a different retail site. So I'm going to choose Dollar Tree. So I'm going to go to dollartree.com.
Alt D selected. HTTP D O L L A R tree.com selected. Enter. https://www.dollartree.com-alert. Alert. Glass vases, party supplies, cleaning and more. Vertical bar. Dollartree.com.
Okay. So again, what I'm going to do is do the same thing that I did for Amazon, and I'm going to navigate by heading here. So I'm going to go to my first heading.
On the hunt for gifts, plan your next store trip, heading level 3.
So it says on the hunt for gifts, plan your first next store trip.
Blank, head over heels for DIYs, visit our value seekers blog. Blank, list box.
I'm going to hit headings again.
Wrapping to top, on the hunt for gifts, plan your next store trip, heading level 3.
Okay, so there's only one heading on this page. And because it's a retail site, I would think there would be significantly more headings to kind of break the content down into different sections, so it would be easier for me to understand and perceive what's happening on the page. So now, instead of, and I didn't do this really last time, but I'm going to have to use now arrow navigation from this one heading to try to understand what's happening on the page.
Blank, link graphic view local ad. Blank, link checkout or ad.
So one thing I've noticed is when I navigated before by heading to this, the content changed. It didn't read the same way. Before, it read different information to me, but I'm going to continue to arrow down.
Blank, link graphic view and store specials. Blank, link and dash store specials. Blank, link graphic view item of the week. Blank, link item of the week. Blank, list box, list box, list box, list box, list box.
So I don't know really what's going
list on. List box, link graphic 16-US glass sports mug with handle, famous dash maker Pilsner glass, 20 link graphic gold plastic charger plate with beaded rim, metallic silver plastic charger plate, and blank. Head over heels for DIYs, visit our value seekers blog. Blank, list box, number Dollar Tree.
So as you can see, like there was those where it said list box, list box, list box. I don't really understand what that's for.
List box, number Dollar Tree.
Number Dollar Tree.
Share your finds and creations. Blank. Expand image from Instagram user on January 12th to expand image blank. Link powered by Wine.
So now I'm going to go up to the top and see what the content's like from the top of the page. So I'm going to navigate up to the top.
Glass vases, party supplies, cleaning and more. Vertical bar. Dollar Tree.
And I'm going to just down arrow.
Po 5,500,003 is loaded.
And I don't know what that even means.
Link graphic store locator graphic your store colon Islandia rad FSB link catalog quick order link graphic order by phone image graphic order by phone 1-877-530-tree.
So it's reading a lot of different content all at once.
Left paren call center hours right paren. Same dash day delivery graphic, same dash day delivery link track orders link graphic shop family dollar.
So again, it's reading a bunch of information all at once.
Blank. Visited link graphic Dollar Tree. Extreme values every day. Search dollartree.com. Search dollartree.com edit. Banner region. Escape. Unlabeled zero button.
All right. So there's an unlabeled button.
Blank. Trending searches. List of 10 items. Hair. Blank. Hair color. Blank. Rustic woodland crisp blank. Halloween costumes. Blank blankets, blank Play-Doh, blank Scott 1000, blank Halloween, blank bleach, blank laundry detergent. List end. Link shop plus account graphic. Account link successfully added to cart.
So it's saying something was successfully added to the cart, and I haven't even looked at anything yet. So that's confusing.
Blank link all departments, holidays, seasons, and sell toys and crafts.
So I'm going to stop here. And this is kind of a contrast to what we saw on Amazon, right? So we saw some things that were unlabeled. We saw information that's confusing. There's only one heading on this page. So a screen reader user would not have the, you know, to really navigate effectively. It's basically one of their main tools that they use to navigate has been taken away from them. And then we had different areas of the page where content was just read all together, and it was multiple items read on one line, which could be, you know, not only confusing to someone with a screen reader, you know, a screen reader user, but, you know, maybe a person that has multiple disabilities where, you know, it's not just a screen reader user, but they may have some cognitive issues as well. So that could be significantly confusing to someone in that position. So this is, you know, the difference between a website that, you know, really focuses on accessibility and one where it doesn't seem that an emphasis on accessibility has been made.